Hello, data fans, and welcome to Nvidia GTC. We're here in San Jose, California. My name is Savannah Peterson. Very excited to be kicking off the day with Kevin Egan on the technical marketing side for Equinix. Thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
You're a CUBE alum, a total VIP.
That's right. My second CUBE interview. Excited to be back.
Yes, it's great to have you back. More importantly, super exciting year for Equinix. 2025 shaping up to be a real big one. Talk to me a little bit about the exciting stuff going on in this booth.
Absolutely, yeah. So we're super excited to be here. Nvidia GTC, we went bigger this year. We've got some really cool models, as you've seen. We've got time-lapse video of one of our liquid cooling installations being done, and we have some demos running on our demo hub. And so, yeah, just excited to engage with customers in a fun way. We wanted people to understand that we are a data center, a high-performance data center company, and a provider. And so we built the data center model to kind of get that, capture people's imagination and give us something to talk about that's a little more concrete than words on a wall. So
yeah, I mean, I think seeing is believing. And one of the things that we all know about Equinix, best in breed data centers, AI ready, all over the world, meeting folks wherever they are. In fact, you've got 268 data centers, 74 major metros, 35 countries across six continents. Yeah. This is no joke in terms of your breadth and depth. Talk to me a little bit about the data center that you have in front of us right here.
Yeah, no, that's great. It's a great intro. So this is a representation of our London complex. The London complex has 10 data centers, and two of them are actually part of our xScale cooperative, our joint partnership, and then the other eight are international business exchanges. And what we built here is London 5. London 5 is really, it's pretty cool because it's 100% sustainable. It's got like 177,000 square feet of data center. I think over 1,250 customers. When you put that into context, just for London 5, this is a major data center. But what's really cool is this is connected to everywhere else in the world. You know, 80% of this is a key part of that European business exchange, runs through that 10 building, that 10 data center Equinix complex, and London 5 is a representation. So yeah, so this was a cool to show that interconnection, because this is connected not only to Silicon Valley, to Dallas, to Atlanta, to Sydney, to Tokyo. It's part of that interconnected business exchange, and five nines, you know, availability, highly secure, so on and so forth. So yeah, this is our latest and greatest model.
You mentioned something that very much caught my attention. You mentioned that this data center is 100% sustainable, and that across your data centers, you are 96% sustainable, if I'm
That's
not
right.
mistaken.
Yeah.
That's extraordinarily impressive. Talk to me about what that means and how you accomplished that.
Yeah, so really that's, we were one of the first providers, data center provider, to come out and with a goal of being 100% sustainable. And really what that means is a combination of, you know, carbon footprint and credits and working with the certain agencies, especially in Europe, as they have to meet these regulations, but also renewable energy sources, and being creative with not only the parts that we select, but the providers that we select for power and water and all the things that come together to get that sustainability rating. We're really proud of that. Good example,
yeah.
You know, we did for Paris.
I was going to say,
yeah.
You've gotten an Olympic Aquatic Center's example for me,
that's
right?
That's right. Yeah, we use some of our return chilled water to heat the Olympic swimming pool at the Paris Olympics, and from our London data centers, so our Paris data center exchange. So that's kind of a neat, you know, neat example of that sustainability in action and being creative.
And the ways that it benefits the communities outside of technology. I mean, who isn't a fan of the Olympics? Speaking of liquid and cooling, we've got a nice little demo in front of us here on the table as well. This is the liquid cooling inside of this data center, correct?
This is an example of a liquid cooling sort of reference design that we had. And this, for those customers who really require, NVIDIA, you know, is a great example, right? They have their super pods and the GB200 that Jensen's talking about in his keynote at this event. You know, this liquid cooling is really required to run that 120 kilowatts per rack. And so what we wanted
to do... Which is impressive.
It's amazing, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's a combination of that liquid pulling that heat directly off of the chips, you know, with that air cooled for the networking and some of the surrounding things. But yeah, this is really amazing. You know, when you look at the, if I was to take you over to SV11 and see, which is why we have a time-lapse video of this going right now, which is super cool to show and kind of demonstrate that build out of a DGX, you know, superpod, that GB200, one of the first enterprise superpods in the world. You would see some massive plumbing coming down from the ceiling, all the power, you know, four individual power drops to each of these racks. So the consumption, but the work per watt is insane also, because those are so much more, you know, productive than the ones before. So the generations keep getting better and we're keeping pace, and we can provide this for our customers who want to do that level of AI training and tuning and inference.
So, your level of innovation inside Equinix must be extraordinarily fast.
Yeah, we're pretty proud of it. It's exciting the way that we're able to, you know, serve our customers and produce not only the facility side, but then also the planning, the operations, the you know, the way that we can do that 3D modeling of their implementations. And that's actually what we're showing on some of our demo hub tools, portals for our customers to access their footprint, you know, and their health and all those things. But then also our smart hands and our services and, you know, the tools that our inside data center services employees have in order to, you know, make sure that you as a customer have the greatest experience, you know, when you come to an Equinix data center. So that's what we're trying to demonstrate.
And that's exactly the reputation that Equinix has. I've talked to a lot of your customers in your community. Everyone knows you're best in class. Final question for you, Kevin. If you could wave your magic technical marketing wand and have everyone, not just at GTC, but in our greater community that you serve all around the world and those you don't yet serve, if you could wave that wand and have everyone know something, or you could teach them something about Equinix today, what would that be?
That's a great question. I just think the fact that we, you know, we shorten the path to really connecting anywhere in the world. That's something we're super proud of, the fabric and the interconnection and the connection that we use. I would love for them to know automatically that when they're partnering with Equinix, you're gaining access to a neutral interconnection partnership with over 3,000, all of our cloud service providers, all of our network service providers, all of our technology service providers. They all run in Equinix, and so that's really what we're after.
I love it, Kevin. What a note to end on. Thank you so much for coming
Absolutely.
Back on theCUBE.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
And thank all of you for tuning in, wherever you might be. We're here at Nvidia GTC in San Jose, California, coming to you from the Equinix booth as a special exclusive coverage today. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.